Hello again, everyone. This is Lori Lambert here at Homewood. It is Sunday night, May 3rd, and the weather has been lovely. I hope you've been enjoying it. Today, I'm going to highlight some of our courageous and incredible healthcare professionals. There are so many of you that we cannot recognize today, so please know how grateful we are. We want to thank all of the nurses, doctors, hospital workers, hospital administrators, aides, and EMTs out there, and we have a few who are close to home. Bruce Bluen writes that Heidi Bluen is the 340B program manager at Haywood Hospital. His oldest son, Kyle, is a critical care tech in their emergency department, and his middle son, Philip, works in the environmental services department. Miranda Walton, his son Kyle's girlfriend, is an RN in the emergency department, also at Haywood Hospital. Linda Rockwood, Mrs. Harris's stepmother, is an RN at Boston Medical Center, where she works in the ICU. Barbara Bonney, Mrs. Harris's mother, is a nurse practitioner in the VA healthcare system. Chantal Diwali McAuliffe, an alumna from 2006, is a phlebotomist at Haywood Hospital, currently on furlough now. Susan Troy, Mr. Troy's mother, works at St. Vincent Hospital in Worcester, Mass. As a quality manager, RN. Chris Harvey, wife of Mr. Harvey and mother of Ms. Harvey, is an RN on Watkins 1, the COVID floor at Haywood Hospital. Heather Harbour, one of our own Winchendon nurses, is an RN and works at Haywood Hospital in the ER. Diana Johnson, Mr. Johnson's wife, is a nurse at UMass Memorial in the ICU, which includes COVID and head trauma cases. Deb Johnson, my sister, works as an RN in the pediatric medical surgical ICU at Boston Children's Hospital. Lisa Langdale, Mr. Lambert's sister, is based in Charleston, South Carolina, and is the South Atlantic VP of Clinical Education for HCA Healthcare. Our own John Harrington is working for DDS, the Department of Developmental Services, taking care of adults with special needs. He spent weeks procuring materials and supplies and setting up a conference room as a triage center with 22 beds in case any residents are afflicted with COVID, since most are elderly. Luckily, they haven't had to use it yet. Mrs. Drogsvold's niece is an emergency room nurse at Mass General Hospital. She is staying healthy by exercising and eating well. Her name is Charlotte Walsh. Also, Charlotte's mother, Mrs. Drogsvold's sister, is an MD in Needham, Mass, who has had to move her practice online during the COVID-19 epidemic. Patients are still able to access her practice through telephone calls and Zoom. Let no patient be left behind. Mrs. Drogsvold's nephew, Gabe Buchanan, is a physical therapist in Philadelphia working with autistic children in a hands-on facility. He loves his profession and has been able to keep healthy despite close contact every day with each of his charges. Alex Alway, the wife of former faculty member Patrick Engelhart, is extended Winch family. She just transferred to the NICU at Presbyterian St. Luke's Medical Center in Denver, Colorado. Carrie Young, parent 19 and parent 21, Andrew and Nolan McDonough's mom, is a registered nurse at Brigham and Women's Hospital in Boston, Mass. And of course, Lori Nolan Kelly, a member of our Board of Trustees, is a VP of Quality and Performance Improvement at St. Francis Hospital, the Heart Center, in Roslyn, New York. She is a doctor of nursing practice. Thank you to this small group and to all others serving in the medical field in the US and in the world. We cannot say enough about your dedication. As Florence Nightingale pledged in 1893, with loyalty will I endeavor and devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care. Although she was speaking as a nurse, the line can be applied to all of our healthcare professionals. We send our love and appreciation your way. Have a great night. Have a great week.